and they wanna see a demise. Eastside just too fast, yeah, I kill them in stride. I love all my haters, they concealing their pride. Went from humble beginners to numerous winners. I took a few losses, you know I'm here to still got chicken to fry. Know some people out here picking a side. Know I'm out here picking a lot. Watching the fakes, watching the snakes, slither, striking the time. TDE, it's the family, we them dominant dogs. Top tiering, when them comments evolve, we out for it all. Rocks out, he ain't dropping the ball. Prime time, who want it with us? Us. Got clarity, longevity, like bust and bust. Ooh. Got too far, and it's the starving, it's and that's a no-no. If I'm hungry, then I'm hunting, always on the go-go.
Problem my whole life. Mama love when I'm living right. Daddy raised me, survive and fight. Now they watching me on prime time. Now they watching me on prime time. Now they watching me on prime time. Been the problem my whole life. Mama love when I'm living right. Daddy raised me, survive and fight. Now they watching me on prime time.
Now they watching me on prime time.
Now they watching me on prime time.
I went out and got everything on my own. Please don't try to give me no advice. What was your two cent and we was down bad broke and my mama couldn't keep on the light. No cat and no dog, we sleeping with mice. Beans and weenies, we ate it with rice. I swore to my mama that I was gonna change my life. I was grinding every night.
First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. And tonight we start week 9 with a good one in primetime, as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Detroit Lions. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week 9? And no return here to start. It's a fair catch, and they will set up shop at the 25. Throwing here on first down. It's taken in by Quentin Johnston. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. In motion right, that's Williams. Now he's going to get it on the jet sweep. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. The Lions at 3-5, two games under 500. Now they were losers last time out, trying to turn things around here in this one.
And it always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement as long as you give them something good to cheer about. So, you know, they just want to come out and play well for their faithful, and I expect them to do just that.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 34-yard line. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Ready?
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Bears are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. We often give credit to the O-line there. Two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, and that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
And they run the option here on first and 10. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. The keeper there turning into a big play of 23 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Here's second and 10. Here's Fields. Pass complete. George Pickens with it. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. You talk about this Lions defense. They come into this one down at the 27th position in the league, Charles, against the run.
As Group talks all the time about wanting to be better, getting stronger against the run. And to me, it all starts up front. You've got to win the line of scrimmage in order to play against the run very well.
And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
A lot of energy in this building tonight, but the opening drive produces three, maybe quiets them just a bit, at least momentarily.
Just a little, right? That's all you're asking for, right? Things just getting started. You know they haven't taken the momentum totally here, but at the same time, they like what they've done here in the early going.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Their second drive here, the ballgame, Charles. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition just 3 after they threw the pick. Their turn now, back out on the field, put together a good drive, and get some points of their own.
Go pink! Black shot!
Here's second and 8. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. They'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He gets it to Johnston. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. So into Bear territory now. This is 1st and 10 at the 36. Trying the left side with Gibbs. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Now here's a throw, it's complete. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 12-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage after it.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. We're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. What's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
Here we go.
Now
we
a
go.
Second and 10.
Smack, red. Black Ultra. Set, go.
They'll set up a throw. And they're going to get it. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. They get to him for a loss of four, and it brings up third down on the sack. Going to need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing.
Light blue. Hey, green.
Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Got it.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
Hey, red.
This is our last chance.
Green jack. Fight, white.
He'll look to throw. He'll find Williams on the slant. And they'll rally and stop him short of the first down at about the six. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Riley Patterson now on for the field goal. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. Patterson's kick is good, and that will tie us at 3-3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal, and yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they come into this one off the loss over the weekend. But you say if you're going to play a Thursday night game, this is the week to do it.
It certainly is, because you get right back out there. You don't have time to dwell on things. And look, your game plan is going to be a little more limited, but so is theirs. So that's when you just appeal to your top players. Guys, you make plays in this one, we out-execute them, we can walk away with a win.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll be taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. Here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Fields on third down. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Fields on first down. Staying on his feet. But in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
Got to give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Now it's Fields. Complete. A gain there of 21 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Off play action. Fields. His throw incomplete.
These two teams, you may remember, they met up at Soldier Field earlier this season with the Bears winning that one. So if they could win again here in Detroit, they'd pull off the season sweep. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 51 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
Now that's a big-time run. Lightning in a bottle, forget it. He exploded out of the bottle for that type of a pickup.
Now a first down throw, Fields. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Touchdown! A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bears have taken the lead. Chase McLaughlin on for the extra point. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
Here we go.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CB, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here because, to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must-wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves. But a loss here, that would move them to 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock.
And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
On play action, they'll throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a 3rd and long.
Come on, set.
Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains.
Ultra, go ultra. Ready.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's airing it out for Williams. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Offenses all over continue to be aggressive, and most people never turn down a shot at a deep ball. But oftentimes, it attracts a little bit of extra attention. And it did on that play, and that one got knocked away.
Taken from just outside the 30. We call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. And the Bears take over.
Here we go.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls because... And this is caught! Touchdown, Bears! A big play there! 68 yards! And the Bears are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Charles, there aren't really any slow receivers, but there's fast and then really fast. He's really fast, and he showed off the afterburners there.
And that he is, because when he took off, I was thinking there's no chance that he could actually reach him with that pass. Yet he did, and he's still sprinting. And just think about what that does for everyone else on his team, because his ability to stretch a field opens things up for the rest of the receivers on the team.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25.
Set,
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Yeah, they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And, Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are. But let's face it, partner. They can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
Yo, Blue. Fury, yellow.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Throws out left. It's caught by Williams. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. It looks like a 12-yard loss there on the first down sack.
Let's go.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Drill green. Smash red. Zoom black. Sack.
Looking to throw. Flush to his right. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approached this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Black Ultra. Yellow, go.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Johnston. They'll get 19 out of this, but it will still bring up a fourth down.
A big gain on the play.
Here's Bryce Behringer now. Fielded just inside the 20. 31 yards on the punt there. And they will take over first and 10.
Here we go.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Here we go.
The ball on the 30. Here's second and 4. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now third down and 7. Fields now to throw. That is caught, and he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
On first down, Fields. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 42. 18 yards the gain for number 18. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. On second down, here's Fields. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
Here we go.
Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two. Back to throw, Fields. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
What an excellent defensive stand there in the red zone. Nice tight coverage. They certainly recognized how important it was to bring up fourth down here.
And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get three before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Got his man. It's Williams. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down.
That's good. We're on Lions. First down. First down.
10 cycles. 40-yard
line.
Green Jack. Ready.
He'll drop to throw. Open man right side is St. Brown. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that'll make it second down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's airing it out for Williams. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Everyone's eyes go to him when he nears the end zone, and that includes the coverage, who took away the easy throwing lanes and forced a high throw.
Here we go. Steel, black. Rail, yellow.
They'll throw now on the final play. And that is incomplete. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be license to take some shots downfield.
Here's Fields now on second down. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
Well, it's too early to figure out what kind of adjustments this defense made at halftime, but that's a good start to the second half. They can now afford to give up more points and fall further behind, so well done to force the punting situation here.
This is taken at the 23. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And the Lions will take over. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they start things off with a carry by Gibbs here. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
Oh, he tried to fit it in back over the middle, and it's intercepted. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown.
And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Phillips, he's not going to bring this one out, so they will begin the drive at the 25.
Here we go.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
Okay, this offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll set up to throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, that kind of run on first down, that's a winning type of a run. That just sets things up for them moving forward as they begin the drive.
And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is, and they've got to continue to swarm the football and hope that someone, while they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and lock it free. They need to get some takeaways as well.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So tack on three more, though this, it's just a rare drive where they did not find the end zone.
Yeah, you're right about that, partner. But at this point, I don't think you're too concerned about that. You just want to possess the football for a while and drain the clock. If you can get three out of it, that's great, too.
Phillips, he's not going to bring this one out, so they will begin the drive at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
They'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down.
Let's go now.
So certainly in a pickle here. They have a mile to go to try to pick up the first. We'll see what they've drawn up. Out of the gun now on third down. Oh, and that is incomplete.
But they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
Drill green. Smash, red. Smash, smash. Ready?
They'll try and throw for it here. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown.
Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense, and certainly a signal caller, Charles, that's thrown all these interceptions, another one there, and this one taken all the way back to the score.
Partner hoping to hold a nice little spot in the postgame highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Phillips now from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Let's go.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out.
And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
A feather in the cap for the defender picking up. Quarterback so far this season, and add another feather in the cap for the coaches too. Excellent game plan, and they had their guys aware of his ability to roll out and how to defend against it.
Here's Tucker. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
I have zero rooting interest in either team in this game. I only want a good game. But with all the offense we've seen from them tonight, it's kind of nice to see the defense step up and make a big play.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were ever going to get him in the backfield. Nice to see him get a stop. And they'll run with Tucker. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It's a loss of four. Now third down. When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there won't be any fast forwarding, partner. I've sat in those sessions before. You end up spending more time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. That's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth. Chase McLaughlin now for the field goal try. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. And his kick is indeed good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, the only silver lining on the other sideline, CD, is that they kept him out of the end zone, but still, that's another 3 points added on to this large lead.
Yeah, no shortage of scoring or big plays on defense in this one. And even up by four possessions, still finding ways to create opportunities and capitalize with points.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Down.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball. And it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
Blaster, six.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Steps away to his left. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards the pick up there. They'll look to throw now on first down. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Back now at Ford Field. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair.
Here we go. Here we go.
Second and 10.
Mega. Ready?
They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He'll find Williams on the slant. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Second and 1. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll look to throw again. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the Bears are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. But with this advantage, this defense knew that passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a way to cap things off, Al, because I think this is part of the game within the game. They see the scoreboard, they see what they can accomplish, and they went for it.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Hold it ready.
Brings up second and 12.
Hawk 70.
And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's tackled at the 38, but they doubled their yardage. The play started at the 19, and they gained 19. On the ground, it's Tucker. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11.
They run. It's Tucker. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Bears on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is 3rd and 7, and he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up 4th down. Here comes the Bears punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback.
On the ready.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish.
They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Blue strike. Blue, go. Ready, ready.
They're going to look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Finds Gibbs on the check down. And down he'll go at the 25. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a 3rd down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation. One that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Looking to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So into Bear territory now. This is 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line.
1st and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Ultra.
They'll set up a throw. He's airing it out for Williams. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. And the Bears are going to have the football at their own 1 yard line. And now, boy, this is a bit of a surprise, to be kind. They accepted the holding penalty, so wipe out the interception, and their defense will stay on the field. Okay, so following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a 1st and 20. Now back to throw. It's caught on the right side, Williams. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards, the final tally. Back to throw here. Finding Williams once more, complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Let's go.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. Back to throw. And this is caught. Well, they get one back. Picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
Well, CD, they just haven't had a whole lot to cheer about or really grasp onto in this game. They've been dominated, but at least they get a late touchdown here, something positive to put on film for tomorrow's session.
Yeah, they're still trying to execute, trying to get some positives on their board and ledger sheet and keep this from being a total loss. Give them credit. They're going down fighting.
Hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down.
On the give, this is their fullback. And trying to push forward, but he is going to be stuffed up in the backfield. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
After a play like that, it should be congratulations all the way around, I think, because if you can stop a big fullback like that, that's not easily done.
Yeah, he does not go down easily. You're right, but he did there. Chase McLaughlin now for the field goal try. From the left hash, this will be a 41-yarder. And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further.
Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to end.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self
and my goodness, another interception.
Well, they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road and help seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
Come on, come on.
The win for the Bears just around the corner. They go down to a knee.
Okay, ready?
And we'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. So this offense, which was humming all game, ends on a negative play. We didn't see many of those as he takes the knee, but what an explosion and a good win.
Can we call it a negative positive play?
There you go.
An oxymoron to end the ball game.
And they can watch the clock go down and celebrate the victory. Well, partner, under the lights in primetime, this offense, they gave the nation quite a show, putting up that many points to come away with what will certainly be a memorable win for them.
And, Brandon, I think it's as simple as this. Some players, some teams, they're just meant for the big stage. And when they get a chance to play in this type of atmosphere, where all eyes are on them and all the lights are...
Nobody do it better than me, not incredibly. I do this competitively, inevitably. These fall in silent when I walk up in the... Nobody do it better than me, not incredibly. I do this competitively, inevitably. These falling silent when I walk up in the building. Worry about their future like I'm here to snatch their children. That line was brilliant. How I'm not already in the millions? Am I not the picture of resilience? Why they test my patience? Hyping all this lame. No one got a brain, they just be liking all the same. This is what the I'm in on in the street games. I'm convinced that nobody is speaking my language. I'ma get it, so listen close when I say this. After every feel stainless.